Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and it's our second video on reciprocal graphs. Now previously, we drew the following graphs using tables of values on reciprocal graphs video 1. And we found that it was a bit of a painful process to draw these graphs. It was quite long-winded to fill in a table of values. I did say to you, however, that I'd like you to learn that graph and that graph, their general outline as it were, but I said what I'd do is I'd come back and I'd give you ways to draw ones like this and this in a slightly quicker, more efficient way. So let's have a go at doing just that. Let's start straight away with an example. Sketch, that's a key word, it's not use a table of values, sketch the graph of y is equal to 2 divided by x subtract 3 and label all the asymptotes. I'm going to take you through a very rigorous way of writing this down. The first thing we're going to look for is we're going to look for the vertical asymptotes. So let's write down what we're doing, the vertical asymptotes. Now you get those by deciding when you get an undefined y value. When are you dividing by zero? So the key is with these reciprocal graphs, you look at the denominator, you decide what x value makes that zero, and that would make you be dividing by zero, which you know you can't do. And it's clear that x is equal to 3 would be the asymptote, because 3 take away 3 would give you 0, right? And in that case, you get y is equal to 2 divided by 0, which is the undefined that you're looking for those vertical asymptotes. So we're going to draw that asymptote in straight away. X is 3. It's going to be somewhere like here, let's say, right? And label in the asymptote x is equal to 3. Then we're going to go for the horizontal asymptotes. Okay, so let's go for the horizontal one. Now, how do we find those? Maybe a little bit more detailed. We have to think what's going to happen as x tends to positive infinity. Let's think about what happens as x tends to infinity, and I'm going to write positive to say that it's going off towards positive infinity here. Let's think what would happen to y is equal to 2 over x take away 3. Now the best way I like to think of it is think of x being a massive number. Think of it being super massive, like 10 million or something. 10 million take away 3 is still a massive number, almost as big as 10 million. 2 divided by 10 million is a tiny, tiny number close to zero, but from positive. So as x tends to positive infinity, y is tending to zero, but all the numbers are positive. It's tending to zero from above. Okay, so it's coming down like this to zero from above. All right, and that's helpful for us. Now to get the other one, we think what happens as x tends to negative infinity, as x is shooting off in this direction. Again, you just need to think of your graph like that. If x was a really negative number, like negative 10 million or something, the bottom here would be like negative 10 million and 3. 2 divided by negative 10 million and 3 would be something, it would be virtually 0, but it would be 0 from negative numbers. So y is tending to 0, but all the time along it's negative numbers, so it's coming to 0 in that direction. So we have a horizontal asymptote of y is equal to 0, so it's important we label that in as well. This one here, y equals 0, is what our graph is tending to as x tends to positive or negative infinity. Let's try and finish it up now. So there is a decent sketch of the graph y is equal to 2 divided by x subtract 3, and we've labelled our two asymptotes there, and we're done. Let's try another one. Pause the video, have a think about this. Okay, let's do what we usually do. Let's think of our vertical asymptote. That's usually nice and easy. So we're trying to divide by 0. We know that when x was equal to 2, y there, which would be 5 over 2 take away x, would sort of blow up. It would sort of tend towards infinity. So our vertical asymptote is that x is equal to 2 here. So let's draw that one in again. Let's label that x is equal to 2. That's going to be our vertical asymptote. Let's get our horizontal asymptote. So to get these, you need to think what's happening as x tends to a massive positive number. So as x tends to a massive positive number, let's think what's happening to this here. 2 take away a massive positive number, like 2 take away a million or something. It's kind of like negative a million, isn't it? It's negative 999,998, in fact. But it's like negative a million. And 5 divided by negative a million, it's nearly 0, but it's zero coming from the negative side. So y is tending to zero, but from negative numbers. So we know it's going to be something like this. Let's think about what happens as x tends to negative infinity now. As x tends to negative, a massive number, let's think what happens to y is 5 over 2 take away x. Imagine x was negative a million. 2 subtract negative a million is 2 add a million and 2. 5 divided by a million and 2, well, it's a positive number, and it's nearly 0. So y is tending to 0, but positive numbers. So you can see our asymptote in this case is that type of thing. So now that's good enough for us to have a decent go at sketching. Now the only thing I haven't labelled in here is I haven't labelled my horizontal asymptote, which would be the line y is equal to 0, and we'd be done. Let's try another one. Pause the video, have a go at this one. Same old stuff. Let's go for the vertical asymptote first. So the vertical asymptote. Well, when are we going to be dividing by 0? We're dividing by 0 if x is equal to 1. That's pretty easy. If x is equal to 1, y is, you know, which is 2 over x subtract 1 to take away 3, well, that would be 2 divided by 0 take away 3, which is undefined. So there we go. That is our vertical asymptote. Let's draw that one in. X is equal to 1, something like this here. And make sure you label it because it asked you. Now we've got to just be a tiny bit more careful here. We want the horizontal.
And what we're
going to do is we're going to consider what happens when x tends to positive infinity. So remember, our graph is 2 over x take away 1 subtract 3. I like to think of x as a massive number, let's say a million. A million take away 1, well, it's virtually a million. 2 divided by a million is a very, very small number, but it's a positive number. So let's just say, for example, it's a tiny number, but it's something like tiny positive number, very small positive, take away 3. So imagine in your head, it's like, say if it was 0.1, it's not 0.1, but say if it was 0.1, take away 3, it's slightly more positive than negative 3. All right, imagine it was slightly more positive than negative 3. So it seems like our graph here is tending towards a vertical asymptote of y being negative 3, and as x tends towards infinity, it's slightly above that line there, so it's an asymptote that's going to look that type of thing. Again, let's imagine x tending towards negative infinity. Y here would be given by that function there. Imagine x being negative a million. Negative a million take away 1 is negative a million 1. 2 divided by negative a million 1, that's a tiny negative number, take away 3. So imagine, if you imagined it being negative 0.1 take away 3, it would be negative 3.1. It's slightly more negative. So it's slightly more negative over here. It would look something like this. And this should be enough for us to draw our graph in. It would look something like this. And that's our graph, y is 2 over x take away 1 take away 3. A nice sketch of that graph. Okay, one more for us to try. Pause the video, have a go here. So I'm going to start off, as usual, with our vertical asymptote. Where are we going to divide by 0? Well, you just have to look here and think, if x is negative 1, that would be 0. So x is negative 1 is going to be that for us. So let's draw that in. Imagine it being here and label that up. X is equal to negative 1 is our vertical asymptote. Let's go for the horizontal one now. So all we've got to do is think what happens as x tends to positive infinity here. Let's see if we can imagine what happens. Imagine x being a massive number, a million, let's say. This then is roughly 2 divided by a million. Okay, and we're doing 2 divided by a million is a tiny positive number. So we're doing 3 subtract a tiny positive. So imagine it's just slightly lower than 3. So let's say 2.99, that type of thing, slightly smaller than 3. So it seems that 3 is our key number here. So y is 3 is going to be our horizontal asymptote. And we know, in this case, as x tends to positive infinity, we're slightly below it. We're slightly below it. We're at 2.9, that type of thing. Let's now go for x being tending towards negative infinity, y being 3 subtract 2 over x add 1. Just got to think about this carefully. If x was negative infinity, right, well, negative a million or whatever, then 2 divided by negative a million is a tiny, tiny, tiny negative number. So we're doing 3 subtract a tiny negative number. Subtracting a negative is like adding. So this is going to be like 3 adding a tiny positive. So you can imagine it being something like 3.0001, that type of number. It's just slightly bigger than 3. It's just above over this side. Like that. And that's our sketch of y is equal to 3 subtract 2 over x add 1. And we're done. And that's it for this particular video. Thanks loads for watching.